right across Australia. This is Sunrise on 7. Now, live from Brekkie Central, Nat and Sherbo.
Hello, welcome to Sunrise on Good Friday. Thanks for joining us. Also coming up this morning, grab the popcorn. The Easter Movie Marathon has begun. Your guide to the best flicks for the whole family this weekend.
But first at 5:30 new this morning, AFL legend Eddie Betts says he fears for his kids' safety, sharing a clip of racist slurs yelled over the fence from a passing car. Let's take a look. The video is already sparking shock across the country. Let's bring in Sarah Jane Bell in Melbourne. Sarah Jane, the kids were just playing in the yard.
Sherbo, they were, and as you say, this video, it's incredibly confronting and it has quickly sparked outrage from not just the AFL world but the broader community, labelled as disgusting, disgraceful and heartbreaking. Security camera vision that was posted to the AFL Greats Instagram account last night shows a car slowing down outside what appears to be his house before the driver yells out the racist slurs. The children who are playing basketball and are believed to be his kids and some of their friends, well, they hear what's happening before running to the side of the court. Now, with the post, Eddie Betts posted, "Aboriginal kids deserve to be able to play safely, free from racism and abuse over the fence. We are not even safe in our own homes. If you know who this is, please let me know that... let them know, rather, that I'm open to having a chat about how much this hurts our kids." Now, as I say, this attack, it has been condemned by AFL clubs, including the Western Bulldogs, who wrote on Instagram that this was disgraceful and sending their love to his family. Now, Eddie Betts did call out the racist abuse that he copped throughout his own career, but this is just another sign that more needs to be done. Sherbo?
It's very confronting. Thanks, Sarah Jane. Here's Nat.
Thank you, Sherbo. King Charles has called for more care and friendship in a special Easter message as he battles cancer. Live to Europe Bureau Chief Hugh Whitfield. Hugh, his recorded message was played at the traditional Maundy Thursday service.
Yeah, that's right, Nat, where Queen Camilla was deputising for her husband at a tradition that dates back nearly 1,500 years, Maundy Thursday or Holy Thursday, the day before Good Friday, where the monarch hands out coins to pensioners, symbolising Jesus washing the feet of his disciples. Now, each year, the same number of coins for the age of the monarch are handed out to men and women. So 75 coins for men today, 75 coins for women, marking the king's age, but it was the queen who was carrying out the duty. These services held in regional UK cathedrals, which is a tradition started by the late Queen Elizabeth. Unable to be there due to his cancer treatment, of course, the king sent an audio message played to the congregation with a focus on kindness.
"We need and benefit greatly from those who extend the hand of friendship to us, especially in a time of need. It is my special prayer today that our Lord's example of serving one another might continue to inspire us and to strengthen all our communities. May God bless you all this Easter."
That call for friendship comes after his daughter-in-law, the Princess of Wales, faced vicious online rumours about her condition before revealing her own cancer diagnosis. The King, still busy today, receiving new ambassadors at Buckingham Palace from Burundi and the Maldives. That augurs well for Easter Sunday, where we do expect His Majesty to be attending the Easter Sunday service at Windsor Castle. Nat.
OK, thank you, Hugh.
Let's get some more news now. Morning, Eddie.
Thank you, Sherbo. Morning, everyone. AFL boss Andrew Dillon has held a briefing with all 18 clubs overnight over the growing drug testing scandal. He said the league will continue with a health-based approach to illicit drug use, meaning no sanctions for players on the first offence. But there is still outrage this morning. Former Victorian Police Chief Commissioner Kel Glare is calling for the resignation of all AFL bosses who knew about off-the-books drug testing. Another round of airport chaos is on the cards today for travellers as they take advantage of the Easter long weekend. Yesterday saw the busiest travel day of the year nationally. But the worst is yet to come for Sydney, with 100,000 travellers expected to pass through the city's airport today. There'll also be heavy traffic for those travelling by road. Double demerit points are in full effect in New South Wales, Western Australia and the ACT across the entire long weekend. Australian wine producers are raising their glasses this morning after China dropped its heavy tariffs on the product. Let's go live now to 7 News political reporter Ben Downey. Ben, this has been a long time coming and a lifeline for our wine industry.
Absolutely, Eddie. The crushing 200% duties are gone, meaning as of this morning, exports for Australian wine can restart, unlocking what was more than $1 billion annual market to producers before the trade dispute between both countries. Even the most optimistic winemakers don't expect trade to snap back to what it was immediately, but without the tariffs in place, the government expects the Chinese market to regain its place as our number one wine export destination. The politically motivated tariffs were imposed after multiple diplomatic rows over COVID, national security and human rights that led to the relations between our nations being frozen. Now that they're dropped, Australia will discontinue its legal proceedings against China at the World Trade Organization. Australian bottles can retake their place on Chinese shelves and wine lists. Maddie?
Thank you, Ben. Residents in Melbourne's east made a distressing call to police overnight when they found a man with life-threatening injuries in their backyard. They made the call shortly before 9 p.m, crews then taking the victim to hospital in a critical condition. Detectives are now investigating whether the man was assaulted. The New South Wales Transport Department is under a bit of fire this morning after it was revealed taxpayers forked out $70,000 sending officials to Spain to watch train tests. The bureaucrats have now flown to and from Spain 5 times in a bid to resolve issues with a new regional train fleet. The Spanish-built trains are already $1 billion over budget and 3 years behind schedule. A mass emergency lockdown has been triggered in Cairns after a gunman opened fire. Let's go live to Sunrise Queensland correspondent Georgia Costi. Georgia, police are still hunting the 3 people involved.
They are, Eddie. This was a brazen act of gun violence that took place in broad daylight in Cairns. Police say it all started when 2 cars collided, but then they say one man got out of his vehicle and fired a gunshot at another man inside the other car, and that man also had a female passenger with him. But that's when things get strange. Police say all 3 of those people involved then fled the scene. Nearby streets and a school as well were sent into lockdown as heavily armed police swarmed the area looking for this group. They did search a home where they thought some of them lived, but no one was there. Eddie, police say that this group is known to each other, and because they know who they are, they also say that it's only going to be a small amount of time before they catch up with them.
Thank you, Georgia. Elite City Boys School Shore is today mourning the death of a boy in Year 11. It's understood Leon Lee suffered an anaphylactic reaction while travelling home from a rowing event with his parents after 10 p.m. The principal describing Leon as a popular and active member of the school community. A former student of the same school tragically died in 2022 during a ski accident in Thredbo. Tasmanian Senator Tammy Tyrrell says she's resigned from the Jackie Lambie network. In the statement, the senator said Jackie Lambie has indicated she's not happy with the way she'd represented the party, then causing a rift. Instead, she will now sit on the crossbench as an independent. 2 Melbourne teenagers accused of running down a pair of cyclists have been arrested again just days after being released on bail. The 16-year-old accused of driving the car has been arrested over a series of violent armed robberies, while a 14-year-old was arrested after leading police in a chase in an allegedly stolen car after being charged over the cyclist's hit and run. This time, both were refused bail. The new media boss for the New South Wales Police Force has lost his job before he even started. Former TV producer Steve Jackson was to be Commissioner Karen Webb's new head of media, trying to improve her image. But almost as soon as the appointment was leaked, there were questions about Mr. Jackson's suitability for the role. Now, the temporary appointment has ceased, authorities saying the candidate needs to be free of external distractions and any media attention. A WA politician is being slammed for appearing on Russian state television congratulating President Vladimir Putin on his election win.
Я бы хотел поздравить мистера Владимира Владимировича Путина.
Port Hedland councillor Adrian McRae was flown to Moscow, where he claimed he'd never seen such a transparent and comprehensive victory. Prime Minister Penny Wong has labelled the election result an insult to democracy. This is the story of the week. A campaign to return social media sensation Molly the Magpie to her human carers has now won the backing of the Queensland Premier. Let's go live to Liam Blount on the Gold Coast. This has gone right to the top, Liam. Now, Molly's best friend, Peggy the Staffy, of course, desperate for her to come home.
That's right, Eddie. And for a second consecutive day, the Queensland Premier has put his support behind a plan to bring the bird home to his best mate. Now, Stephen Miles telling the media yesterday, common sense needs to prevail. Molly the magpie was rescued as a chick by a Gold Coast couple and has formed a unique bond with their pet Staffy. That unique friendship, that special bond, it's blown up online, it's gone viral, and that did catch the attention of authorities. And so earlier this month, Molly was surrendered to the Department of Environment. Now, the department says its priority is for the welfare of the bird, but it is considering a number of options regarding its future care. Now, one of those options, and the one that Premier Stephen Miles is pushing for, is for the department's officers to help the family obtain a wildlife permit. That way, Molly can be legally returned home, a resolution that many following this saga are rooting for. Eddie?
It's the little wing on the back for me, I think, Liam. Thank you for that. We're going to stay on that story.